My name is Till Eisenberg. I'm from Friedrichshafen and the project manager of the project Simon. Simon weighs about 5 kilograms and has a diameter of 32 centimeters. He has a velocity of about 1 meter per second, which is rather slow, but it's quite comparable with the normal movement of a crew member. He's equipped with a display of 8 inches, which was chosen because this gives the ability to put on to display a complete face. Simon stands for Crew Interactive Mobile Companion, and it's meant to be a social, interactive, free-flying object who shall assist the crew during extensive tasks and to reduce stress. Simon will assist Alexander Gerst during his next mission. He will assist him during 2 different tasks, so he will be able to provide him with the good advices during complex procedures, as well as assist him in social interaction or by social interaction, and will provide additional data to the science group, like video data for or during complex tasks to validate the exact processing.
Simon is a free-floating artificial intelligence, and when he will be activated, this is kind of a historical moment. So we are very happy that Simon will be the first artificial intelligence in space. That for us, this is a piece of the future of human spaceflight. I mean, if you go out to the moon or to Mars, so you cannot take all mankind and engineers with you, but with an artificial intelligence, you have instantly all the knowledge of mankind.
If Alexander Gerst has certain questions to that experiment he's working on, Simon has quite deep knowledge on that experiment. So he can really get inside the experiment and you can ask questions that are beyond the procedure.
During the times when there is connectivity, all the communications go back through the cloud. So all the AI work is being processed at the cloud. Natural language, all the training and tailoring we did happens in the cloud, which also means we can enhance it from the Earth anytime and make it smarter constantly to help Alexander and the team to use it.